What you don't realize is that Britney's making you all this money, and all you do is write a bunch of crap about her.
Raw Dog News.
Raw Dog News. I've really super been missing everyone while I'm here in Texas.
So you wanted to talk about Free Britney.
Well, Free Britney, the reason why there are so many reasons why Free Britney is real. You know, we all would walk around and laugh in the past 10 years about some, do you guys remember that YouTube video with that guy in drag basically with the makeup, and he was like, oh, leave Britney Spears alone, leave her alone, and everyone made fun of him, and everyone used him for other things. It made it to talk soup, it made it to E! News Network, it made it to TMZ, it made it to Young Hollywood, it made it to all of those outlets. Do you remember that? You know, leave Britney alone. So basically what happened was, I don't know if any of you people have realized that the older you get, and I'm Britney's age range. I'm 2 years older than Britney, 2 grades ahead of her. So everyone knows in our age range that by now, about 75% of the people who we know at some point, we think, had some type of bipolar disorder, correct? Would you say that? Maybe not 75, maybe about 60.
I guess. I don't know, but sure. Yeah. It's pretty common.
I wasn't lucky enough to get diagnosed with that. I just got general anxiety disorder. But, you know, what can you do? We always strive harder the next time. Maybe I will get that 80s Ritalin. You never know. Either way, the point that I'm trying to make is that her bipolar disorder was used, abused, gambled, and you know, juiced to the umpteenth degree by her father. I am someone who has been thinking about this when I'm seeing it blasted everywhere, to be honest, because she is 40 years old, and I can't even imagine what she's going through. I'm about to be 42. She's 40 years old, and she has had her father for the past 13 years decide for her what type of birth control she takes, when she takes the birth control. Are you serious? This is a sick cult. How is her father, I mean, this is some, you know, think about the Jacksons and Michael Jackson. Think about that in 2021. You know, this girl is 42 years old. She still managed to function and support her entire family, right? She supported her entire family and still does. She is not on drugs currently. I actually follow her on Instagram. She's a little delight. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
there,
I mean, how
there
could...
These transcripts that came out, these... I'm sorry, what were you saying?
No, how could someone who needs to be totally controlled do, like, what did she do, like, 4 years in Las Vegas every day?
Exactly! This bitch is functioning more than everyone else we know!
Right,
she's
right.
She's up on Instagram, she's hosting parties, she's still, and you know, Paris Hilton's on the straight and narrow and, like, does good things in society at this time. So, you know, we've all, everyone's grown up a little bit, and they're, and, you know, and they're friends, and she's not doing anything wrong. Yes, she was fucked up and a bit bipolar when she shaved her head. What is that now? 10 years ago? Let me put it this way to you. Let's think about everything that we've done 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 20 years ago. We are all lucky to be alive.
Right.
And this poor girl fucked up as well, and she had some bipolar that wasn't treated. Big booga booga fucking deal. You know how many people I know with bipolar, they've either got a treat or something. Like, there's worse cases than other cases. But the bottom line is that her father used the shit out of the bipolar, is controlling her like Hitler, tells a 40-year-old woman when she can and can't be taking birth control. Now it's an IUD. I don't know. There's something. The transcript said a lot. And as far as the money goes, like, really? You're going to say somebody's incompetent who's paying for the entire family? Give me a fucking break, bro.
Right. It's they won't let her remove her IUD to have another kid. But her two other children, teenagers now, are fine. Dad, Kevin Federline, fine. Everybody's cool. Like, there's no issue with the family. You know what I mean? No one's going crazy. And ultimately, if she had had her little freak out and didn't have any money or wasn't famous, she would never have been put in conservatorship. That doesn't happen. Like, you know what I mean? Like, in just common everyday life, do you know anybody who's ever been in this situation? No, we don't.
No. It's crazy. The reason why the age to me matters because I'm feeling this situation. Because I remember this. I literally have always been two grades. I'm class of 97. She's class of 99. Something like that. Always been two grades ahead of her. That's, we're like the same. We would be the same cliques at school, everything. So I've thought about her and connected to this. To think about the idea that a family member would do this to you, tell you you're incompetent, and try and take control of your entire life and your body. Mm-hmm. In your early 40s, when you have actually been completely functioning in society, most likely everything done to you is blown out of proportion for the media, because at the time people cared about celebrities. Now no one gives a fuck about a celebrity because now everyone's a YouTube piece of shit.
Right.
LOL.
Right. Well, like, exactly. So if you take a look at the whole duration that this has been going on, nobody is stopping her from being crazy, right? Like, internally.
Right.
Like, she could just one day, you know, repaint her house some crazy color and, I don't know, just do weird shit that people would notice and say, oh, of course, this person should be controlled. But she hasn't done anything weird at all over this whole time. And it's not like the people surrounding her or any, you can't, like your crazy friends, for instance. The other group who notices the crazy person, we can't stop that person from being crazy. You know what I mean? We could put the person in a safe place, where they couldn't hurt themselves, give them medication and stuff, but we're not going to make them, we're not going to change their behavior. That has to come from inside, and clearly, Britney Spears is a normal person.
Yes, thank you very much. Put it in perspective. How many of our friends or family members are probably undiagnosed level of bipolar on the spectrum? Just like how we say, you know, 80s kids like me are in the ADD spectrum when they used to throw Ritalin at us in the 80s. You know what I'm saying? It's the same fucking thing, but people go undiagnosed because why would you want to? And if everybody uses it as an advantage to get you, especially if you have money.
Think about it this way.
The most more...
Right. Yeah, think about it this way. Remember... recently, over the last couple of years, our kind of, you know, new favorite, you know, young 20s pop star, Demi Lovato, everybody. So she OD'd, nearly died, had some kind of stroke and brain damage.
Came back out and said, no,
I'm even though I nearly died, I'm California sober now. That is as crazy, if not way more crazy, than anything Britney Spears ever did. Demi Lovato should be put under conservatorship. I'm saying that right now. Demi Lovato should be controlled and put under conservatorship.
Yep. And
or Britney should be let go. Either one. You have a choice. You can either let her go or put Demi Lovato under conservatorship. Like, there needs to be. There you go. That's the answer.
My vote for Raw Dog News is that fuck Demi Lovato. I don't care what she does. Free Britney. 100%. Britney needs freed. This is terrible. This is abusive. This is stupid. She's more normal than most motherfuckers we know. And this is just gone way too far.
Raw dog news. Way too far.
You should not let anybody raw dog.
Super too far.
See, they're raw dogging her.
Do not raw dog. This is not.
Everyone's raw dogging everyone.
Raw dogging is not funny.
It's not funny.
This matters.
Raw dog news.
It's really not.
A term that is considered slang, and it means unprotected.
So this is something
what
I made.
What you realize is that Britney's making you all this money, and all you do is write a bunch of crap about her.
Raw dog news.
We can just listen to it.
You make.
Her song is called "Give Me More" for a reason, because all you people want is more, 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 more.
This is from the movie Spring Breakers.
Okay. Britney feels she is under a constant microscope, and she's been painted in the worst light.
So yeah, this is the Raw Dog Britney promo.
Britney also told the court that members of her conservatorship were at times emotionally abusive. The singer says that the conservatorship has left her feeling depressed, angry, and alone.
It's sad.
Am I okay? Yes, I'm totally.
She's just lying here.
I love freedom. I love independence. I'm taking a break right now because
she's scared and lying. She's not okay.
Will I ever take the stage again? I have no idea. I'm having fun right now. I'm a transition in my life, and I'm enjoying myself.
Mm-mm.
Britney has said, through her attorney, that she would not perform again as long as her dad remains one of her conservators.
There you go.
Raw dog news. Raw dog news. Raw dog news.
So what's this about a camel?
So I'm here in Texas with the family, and we went to Hill Country outside, about an hour outside of Austin. And we were inclined to kiss a camel on the lips. Until I realized that I may be ground zero for camel COVID-21. And, you know, that's been bucked. So I need to let that out now. What I don't want is for something to happen and then all of a sudden the politicians tell us there's COVID-21. It's from an exchange with a camel with a family. And then it gets back to me, that would be pretty humiliating. So I would rather come out in public right now, put all my cards on the table, and let everybody know that myself and my son did kiss an actual camel here in Hill Country on the lips. If that camel had a new strain of COVID and it gets mixed with the Delta Mutant Ninja Africa India AIDS, COVID, then I will be the new ground zero for camel COVID at Raw Dog News.
All right, you heard it here first. Stay away from Ashley and her kid because they might be carriers of Camel Rona. Don't go anywhere near them.
Camel Rona 2021.
All right.
Don't hate the player, hate the game.
That's true. This has been a very interesting episode of Raw Dog News. Maybe Britney should go visit a camel and kiss a camel. Maybe that would help out.
I will bring the camel personally to Brittany. She actually, I think, has a house close to me.
Okay, we can put it out there that, Brittany, if you're listening, we'd like to invite you to Hill Country, just outside of Austin, Texas, to come with all of us to kiss camels.
I agree that, and she should be part of it. I already feel a spiritual bond with Brittany. I hope I meet her sometime. But you know what? I will reach out to her in Instagram DM at an appropriate time.
Right. You should do it in the morning when everyone's more active.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. When she might be more active as well.
Right. Eating her oatmeal and or whatnot. All that.
I do follow her on Instagram. She's really, really, she does cheer, she cheers me up. I really like this girl.
Well, that's cool. I've actually had conversations with Brittany.
Oh, yeah?
Sure.
Where?
I think it was, Twitter, maybe? I'll have to look it up.
Yeah, definitely look it up. And, you know, maybe one day Brittany will be in our new Raw Dog News posse.
Sure. I think she should come on. I think she should come on the show and we can talk about everything that's been going on and what's next. Because, you know, she's 39, turning 40. She's got a lot of good years left, you know, a lot of performance for performing to do.
Absolutely. Look at J-Lo. Look at J-Lo at 50. Damn, girl. And Brittany, she's gorgeous. Here's the thing. Brittany needs to break free from her dad. I am not a fan of her dad, I can already tell. That's what it is.
That's right. Okay. Yeah, I think that's about it. We covered all the bases, like we do on Raw Dog News. So what's coming up, though, is very interesting. A lot of big stuff coming up. I'm going to be interviewing a comedian stripper. I'm going to be interviewing a dominatrix type person. That should be interesting. These people have been coming to me and saying, "Hey, I want to get on the Raw Dog News." So I'm open to all kinds of topics. Tomorrow on Monday, I'm going to be interviewing the father of a young lady from Florida who was in a shootout with the police and ended up getting shot. She survived, but she's looking at a lot of jail time now. It's a real kind of bonding.
Oh, wow. You have that set up?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Like, people shouldn't get confused about the funny stuff we do on, you know, on the Raw Dog, because there's other important stuff that we do too, like real investigative journalism. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So sometimes 100%. It's funny, sometimes it's serious, and if you know it's serious because it says in the description a serious matter. That's how you know. Otherwise, you're going to get the regular Raw Dog chaos.
Yep, serious matter. That's the way. You're either going to get Raw Dog, and that's Raw Dog, or you will get it and it will be stamped serious matter.
Right. Now,
that's a good way to flag everything.
When you tell your stories, you know, we call that "and another thing" with Ashley. When you have your, like, little stories about remote learning, Camel Rona. Mm-hmm.
Distance learning, Camel Rona.
Right. You did another one.
Mercury Gatorade.
Right. All of that. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we're developing, we're growing. We the video I made about the girl, about the shootout, that's received over 7,000 views at this point. In like 3 days.
That's pretty impressive.
It's pretty impressive.
It's coming.
We're doing it, and it's pretty exciting. And if people out there want to support what we do here, because we're not making any money off of this, we're doing this because we like doing it, if you want to financially support what we do, you can go to patreon.com/marcusparrish. Patreon.com/Marcus Parrish. And what you'll find there is a bunch of DJ mixes and paintings. Now, those mixes and paintings are for people who contribute $2, $5, $10, $20 to $50 a month to support what we do. In return, you get music and art. So it's a pretty sweet deal. Even at the lowest tier at $2, you still get a bunch of cool stuff, like actual physical, like paintings mailed to you, like real stuff, real like treats, you know.
Think about what an amazing deal that is for $2. Nobody gets anything, especially in California.
$2 a month.
That's pretty much the best deal that I've heard.
Right. $5 a month, $10 a month. At $10 a month, you get actually a bunch of stuff. You should just go take a look at the website. It's better to see it than to have it explained. But yeah, that's what we do. We're all about Raw Dog News, the parent channel of our network. Channel Aurelius is, they're doing great. So yeah, it's looking good.
Love you all.
We love you all. And I guess we'll see you.
Camel COVID 2021 kisses to all.
That's right.
From Texas.
So what's this about a camel?